Week 11 is here in CAA football, and there's several big games on Saturday's slate. We start with an in-state battle in Williamsburg between two of the league's top three teams as William & Mary hosts James Madison. It's a matchup of the Tribe's league best rushing attack, which averages over 200 yards per game, against the Duke's defense that is number two in FCS, giving up only 63 yards per game on the ground. William & Mary head coach Mike London knows the JMU defense provides a formidable challenge.
Yeah, they're the complete package in terms of they'll get after the passer. They're great run stoppers. They run well as a unit. They can make plays. Individuals that can make outstanding plays.
The variety of weapons in the Tribe rushing attack has caught the attention of Duke's head coach Kurt Cignetti.
They have a lot of speed on offense. Start with quarterback. You got to contain the quarterback. Can't let him pull the ball. Run the outside zone, let him pull it. You can't do that. And he's elusive. And then 28 obviously can fly. And they got different ways to get him the ball and try to get him on the edge.
The other team at the top of the CAA standings, 8th-ranked Villanova, returns home to face a Stony Brook squad that's on a 3-game winning streak. As the Wildcats try to move one step closer to a conference title, head coach Mark Ferrante says the formula is simple.
We're just going to have to, again, try to play consistent, try to minimize the penalties, try to win the turnover battle, try to play, assignment football, alignment and assignment football.
The Seawolves are playing as well as any team in the CAA over the past month, and head coach Chuck Priori says winning the turnover battle has been a big key.
Three really good weeks of creating havoc, I'd say, and being able to get the turnovers. We've gotten ourselves back on point with that, which has really helped our field position and time of possession. So I'm real pleased how they played.
Richmond and Delaware both are riding 2-game winning streaks coming into Saturday's contest. The Spiders recorded a season-high 7 sacks in last week's victory over Towson and have 13 over the past 2 games. Blue Hens head coach Danny Rocco says it all starts up front for Richmond.
I think it starts up front with that defense, not minimizing any other part of it, but I think what you see when you turn on the film is a front four, a front seven that really attacks and tries to create havoc against your offense.
Blue Hens quarterback Zach Gwynn is coming off his best performance of the season in last week's victory over William & Mary, and Spiders head coach Russ Huseman has taken note of his growth.
He's just getting better and better, and that's what happens. When you don't play a whole lot and then all of a sudden you get thrown in the mix, you got to kind of get yourself to a point where you're used to the offense, used to playing, seeing things. It's easy to do in practice, but once you get with live bullets, and he has gotten to a point where he's legitimately hard to defend.
After registering their first win over an FBS opponent since 2000, Rhode Island returns home to play New Hampshire. The Rams are currently 6-3, and head coach Jim Fleming knows what his team will need to do to be in the discussion for a playoff berth.
Our ability to finish and our desire to prepare accordingly and put our best on the field for the next 2 football games is critically important and would be a fantastic finish to be able to get it done and be able to get an opportunity to represent the conference in the playoffs.
New Hampshire head coach Sean McDonald has been impressed by the overall play of Rhode Island and knows his team has a tough assignment.
So they're doing it in all 3 phases, and Flem's got them playing well, and we're going to have our hands full going down to Meade Stadium on Saturday.
Elon and Towson will both try to bounce back after losses a week ago. The Tigers' offense is led by running back Jerry Howard, who's run for over 400 yards in the past 4 games. Phoenix head coach Tony Trisciani talks about how difficult he is to defend.
Size and speed, and he's a pretty good hurdler, as we've seen the last couple weeks as well. We gotta make sure we wrap up, get a lot of hats to the football with him. Run our feet on contact. He's not going to be easy to get to the ground.
Elon's offense features one of the conference's top quarterbacks in Davis Cheek. His talent and decision-making and ability is what makes him stand out, according to Towson head coach Rob Ambrose.
He's wiser. He's been to the carnival. He's seen the puppet strings. He knows what's real and what's not. He's probably, I don't know, you count him up quarterback reps in this league. Who's had more? Seriously, in the last so many years, probably him. And because of it, with that, we kind of, skill set and that wisdom, yeah, he's extremely dangerous.
UAlbany, which is coming off a win over New Hampshire last Saturday, steps out of conference play to play Morgan State. Great Danes running back Carl Mofor turned in an outstanding performance against UNH with a career-high 222 yards on 45 carries. Head coach Greg Gattuso talks about his record-setting day.
We really needed to hold on and win the game, and we've been in these nail biters every week. And you know, the mistakes in critical moments have hurt us. And I just really trust him with the football in his hand. And
Maine also takes on a non-conference opponent as the Black Bears travel to FBS member UMass. Head coach Nick Charlton says his team welcomes the challenge of facing teams at a higher level.
What that does is it puts a major onus on winning, you know, your conference games like it would with any situation or any team in this league. And having the opportunity to win one or two of these games certainly helps you in what your ultimate goals are.
Here's a look at the schedule around CAA football.